Gaming Bolt presents 15 things you need to know before you buy Resident Evil 7. Resident Evil 7 Biohazard is on the horizon, and every day brings us new leaks about what the game will contain. For some, the recent entries in the series have served as a red flag, telling them to find their zombie horror elsewhere. But with Resident Evil 7's apparent return to its roots, and the joy that recent games like Outlast and Alien Isolation have brought, many may be interested in getting back into the series. To help consumers gauge their interest in the upcoming game, we've compiled a list of 15 things you need to know before you buy the game. A mysterious helper. Throughout the game, a mysterious character will call on the phone. When you hear a phone ringing, seek it out. The caller has important information about the narrative and the progression of the game. Is he or she a returning character from the previous games? Who that character is anybody's guess, but that person will be pivotal to the game's plot. VR support timed exclusive to the PS4. While Resident Evil 7 was built to be an experience that functioned outside of VR, there's no doubt that VR will deepen the experience of trying to find Ethan's wife and escape the Baker family. The only snag? VR will remain exclusive to the PS4 for a year after release. Sorry to everyone with an Oculus Rift or an HTC Vive. You'll have to play on your desktop in non-VR mode. Some monsters were made with real meat. In one of the most disturbing and fascinating development practices we've ever heard of, a number of Resident Evil 7's monsters were built using actual flesh. Rather than working from 3D models, the design team hired makeup artists to build the monsters with actual meat and used photogrammetry to render them into the game world. It's a strange practice, but we're sure will lead to some of the most disturbing monsters in a video game yet. The game will support HDR and PS4 Pro update. Resident Evil will support HDR and PS4 Pro updates, ensuring that you get the most out of your graphics processors. If you upgraded to the PS4 Pro this year, you won't have to worry about being held back by older machines. If you're playing on PC, Resident Evil's lighting will create an atmosphere that is eerie and unnerving. HDR support will improve lighting in many different ways, and the Pro version will most likely up the resolution up to 4K. Furthermore, the game is confirmed to run at 60 frames per second, so it's expected to run smooth regardless of whatever platform you plan to play the game. The Holoforms. Though Resident Evil 7 is continuous with the rest of the series, it will boast a collection of new monsters for players to try and survive against. This new strain of bioweapons are called Holoforms, and while many of their features remain a mystery, it seems that they will be similar to the hunters featured in other Resident Evil games and difficult to fight off, demanding that you dismember them rather than outright DPSing them down. Save system. Resident Evil 7 will allow players to save as much as they want, letting you alleviate some of the stress that comes with playing a survival horror game, and guaranteeing that you'll never be left needing to play extended sections of a game multiple times when you come up against a particularly stubborn foe or untenable situation. Once you complete the game, however, you will unlock the Asylum/Madhouse difficulty, in which saving will be severely limited. This will certainly add to the game's replay value, letting fans run back through the House of Horrors with the added threat of serious consequences on death. Boss battles. The ominous and troubled tenants of Resident Evil 7's rural setting are the Bakers, a family that definitely has more to them than meets the eye. They appear to have massive health pools that will require more than just a headshot to take down. Wise players will stockpile ammo in preparation for encounters with them, though even then you may need to retreat. It will be possible to stun the Bakers with a certain number of shots, buying you time to reposition and reload. The Codec. Ethan wears a watch called the Codec, which will act as the game's primary interface and allows players to check up on their health. You can consider it as an evolution of the user interface found in the first few Resident Evil games. Weapons will be scarce. In an attempt to get back to its horror-based roots and away from set-piece scenes of Resident Evil 6, Resident Evil 7 will be less about gunning things down and more about figuring out when to use your precious few bullets. Throughout the game, cages unlocked with coins will contain weapons, health, and upgrades that players can use to improve their chances as they navigate the mansion. The game's developers have stated that they didn't want the anxiety that comes from playing the game to be without release. You won't always be powerless, but you will need to be careful about when you use the tools that you have. If you're looking for a shootout, this may not be the game for you. VHS tapes will enter players into small scenarios. Throughout the game, there will be VHS tapes that contain minigames. These minigames will change up the dynamics and mechanics of the primary narrative, allowing players to experience different perspectives and unique scenarios that might not have made it into the game, where players were given solely Ethan's perspective. Not only will they provide new mechanics, but also a deeper look into the narrative of the game. The game will run 14 to 16 hours. Resident Evil 7 seems like it will run for a good length. It won't be so short that you're left wondering why you paid so much for it, and it won't be so long that it grows repetitive, boring, or predictable. Psychostimulants will be there to help you out. Throughout the game, you'll have the option to use psychostimulants to highlight nearby objects and make them easier to find. The duration of the stimulant's use will be severely limited, however, so it doesn't seem like you'll be able to use it at all times. Use is also completely optional. If you want to shun them in the pursuit of a more immersive experience, it will be entirely possible to do so. Fighting head-on will be dangerous. Because ammunition is so limited, choosing when to fight and when to run will be a serious decision, each time an enemy is encountered in Resident Evil 7. Ethan isn't much faster than the enemies either, so environmental awareness and caution will be vital to staying alive. If you are caught off guard with no recourse, you will be able to block incoming attacks to try and mitigate the damage. Previous Resident Evil games references. While Resident Evil 7 does represent a return to the game's roots, it isn't a reboot. The game takes place after the events of Resident Evil 6 and will reportedly refer back to the events of the previous games often. Furthermore, there will be secrets and Easter eggs of older Resident Evil games presented to players in a very clever way. What is that clever way? Well, we don't know yet. The game will feel more like being inside a horror film than an action one. Resident Evil 6 saw its cast of characters traveling the globe, fighting giant zombies, massive invisible snakes, and jumping motorcycles off improbable obstacles. Resident Evil 7 seems like it will scale way back, and from the shots, it seems more like the last few episodes of True Detective's first season. The environments seem claustrophobic, filthy, bug-infested, and insidious in a way that goes deeper than just zombies jumping out of dark corners. In short, the developers are aiming for a B-movie style, unlike the Hollywood style of the previous games. And that'll be about it for this one. If you guys like what we're doing at Gaming Vault, please consider subscribing to our channel, and I'll see you guys on the next video.